Okay, are we ready to sing? Remember the song? Is that the one that you remember? Okay, we're going to sing He is Lord. I do not have the visual. I think we can sing it. That's the song you remembered, right? Okay, let's sing. And you're going to start off first, Lilla. Okay.
I feel kind
of okay, one at a time. Come on up, Lilla. Oh, be careful, little eyes. What you see, okay. Oh, be careful.
Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little eyes, what you see. Oh, be careful, little ears, what you hear. Oh, be careful, little ears, what you hear. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little ears, what you hear.
What you look at.
Yes. So if you are looking at something and you hear that little voice inside that says you really shouldn't do that, what is that? That's your conscience. Yeah, maybe you shouldn't look at it. Okay, oh, be careful, little mouth, what you say. What's that mean? we say stuff to hurt our brothers and our sisters and our friends? No, we don't. We be careful what we say. And before you say something, you should think, is this going to hurt somebody or make them feel better? Okay. Oh, be careful, little ears, what we hear. If we hear some bad story about somebody, do we keep repeating it?
No.
You just let it go. Okay. Oh, be careful, little mind, what you think. Oh, what do you think that means, Junior?
Be careful with your head.
That's right. If you know you're thinking about something, you shouldn't think about something else and don't think about it. Okay, now the next song we're going to do is I Can Know God. And we have started this one for this theme, and we'll have River and Sophia come help. Okay, this one is a new song, so we are learning this one in this theme, okay? And I love the words for this, because knowing God isn't just for adults, it's for kids too.
For this day and your blessings that you've given to us. We thank you for each and every person who came today to be a part of this service. Lord, we're asking that you would speak to our hearts as you already have through the songs. Lord, you know about what is before us in the story and all that is there. Lord, we want you to speak and to be a part of our life. We want you to be the king of our life and to direct us in all that we do as we give our heart to you, Lord. We pray these things in thy name.
Okay, now the very first Sunday we did this, we sang, Jesus loves me. Okay, and who does Jesus love? Who does God love? Who did I tell you? Who did I tell you?
Jesus.
Who does he love? Who does Jesus love? He loves?
Everyone.
He loves everyone. And he loves, what's your name?
Junior.
He loves Junior. Who else does Jesus love? He loves Sophia. Who else he loves, Davia? Who does he love? Who does he love? And who does he love?
Me.
And who does he love?
Everyone.
Yes, but who does he love right now?
Everyone.
Okay. They're not going to cooperate, are they? Okay. So Jesus loves you. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter what background you are. Jesus loves you. And he made you. And he made you a very special person. And he has a very special plan for your life. So we're going to sing Jesus Loves Me. God loves us anyway, and he's wanting us to come to him asking for forgiveness. Okay, where's my helper? Okay, we started out with, what was this color represent?
Gold.
What?
Golden.
Golden. And what's the golden represent? Yeah. What's golden?
God.
What's up there? Okay, he's up there, yeah, but what's up there? What does it, where is God? He is in
a town with gold. Heaven.
What did she say?
In heaven.
Heaven! In heaven, there's golden streets. Okay, so gold represents heaven. And what does the black represent?
Sin.
Our sin. And who has sinned? Does anybody know? The scripture says that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. It doesn't matter who we are. We have sin in our hearts. And today we're going to talk about the red. And we're going to find out what that stands for. This stands for salvation. And that is how we get rid of the sin that's in our heart. Okay. Has ever anyone ever made you a promise? Yeah? What's the promise, Beth? Maybe somebody promised to take you to get ice cream, and then they got busy and couldn't go. Has anybody ever done something like that? Yeah? And how do you feel when they don't keep their promise? Yeah?
Sad.
Sad. Well, I'm going to tell you something. God always keeps his promise. God never fails in that area. If he has promised us something, he will do it. If God says it, he will do it. Okay. So God promised a Savior would come and give us salvation. The color of red is what we're talking about, salvation. And God did. Who knows? I know this is what, June, but what was the Christmas story about? Who can tell me what Christmas represents? God promised a Savior would come. And we're going to talk about that today. We're having Christmas. Okay. After God sent Adam and Eve out of the Garden of Eden, they made a home together and started family. And the number of people on earth grew and grew and grew, and people spread all over the earth. And many years passed, and God continued to remind people that he was going to send someone who would defeat Satan, God's enemy, and free people from their sins. After 4,000 years, after God made that promise to Adam and Eve, God kept his promise. It took 4,000 years for God to keep his promise, but he still kept it. That's a long time, isn't it? Yeah, long time, 4,000 years. At just the right time, God sent an angel to a young woman named Mary, and the angel told Mary an exciting message. God had chose her to be the mother of the promised Messiah. Mary was engaged to a man named Joseph, and the angel also went to Joseph and told him what was going to happen. He told Joseph that his name would be Jesus, which means the Lord saves. And finally, the promised Savior who would take away sin was coming. For thousands of years, since the very first people disobeyed God, which was Adam and Eve, sin had been in the world. Okay, we'll go to two. Before the baby was born, Mary and Joseph traveled to Bethlehem, and they had to go there because the governor wanted more money and commanded people to go to the cities where they were born to pay more taxes. This was exactly as God had planned it many years before when he said the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem. This was another clue that Jesus was the Messiah. Mary and Joseph had to stay in a place where animals were kept. What would be in a barn? Tell me quick, what would be in a barn?
Animals.
Okay, what kind? Give me a kind of animal.
Sheep.
A sheep would be in a barn. What else? A cow? A pig? What do you think?
A horse.
A horse? Yes, okay.
A chicken?
What do you say over here?
A dog?
What else?
Baby goats.
Baby goats? Oh, could be anything. What about a kitty? We haven't said a kitty. Yeah, okay.
And a puppy, too.
Maybe a puppy. Yes, you've got a beautiful little puppy. Okay, so all these things were in the animal. Were in the barn, and that's where the animals were stayed. And that's where baby Jesus was born. Now, is a barn clean? It is? No, it's not clean. A barn can be very dirty and very dusty. Is that a place for a newborn baby to be born?
Yes.
No, it's not. It's too dirty for a baby. Well, the baby was born in the stable, in the dirt, just as God had said and as he had promised. The baby grew into a young boy, and then to a teenager, and then to an adult. Later in Jesus' life, Satan tempted him to sin and to go against God's way, and Satan wanted Jesus to doubt God's love and promises, and that's what Satan did to Eve back in the Garden of Eden. Only Adam and Eve listened to Satan. Do you think Jesus listened to Satan this time?
No,
he did not. He did not listen to Satan, and thank goodness he didn't, because if he had listened to Satan, we could not have the salvation plan. When Jesus was about 30 years old, he began to travel and to teach people, showing them that he was the Messiah, the Savior God had promised long ago. In fact, Jesus is God himself. He did many miracles to show the people that he has the same power as God, because he is God. And maybe go over and just show him so the little ones can see them. Just come along here, put down low. Okay, can someone tell me a miracle that God did when he was on earth? Yes. He raised people from the dead. What else did he do? Did you see river? Did you see the picture? Okay. What else did God do? He fed 5,000 people with a little wee lunch. That'd be a miracle, wouldn't it? 5,000 people, and there was still stuff left over. Okay, so God did miracles. And many years before Jesus lived, God told people the Messiah would do miracles. So that was another sign that God was keeping his promise. These are only some of the many clues which God gave, which would show that Jesus is the Messiah. Even though God had made many promises about the Messiah, there were still people who did not believe. They didn't trust God's promises, and they did not come to know the true Jesus. God's promises about the Messiah had come true, but some people, as I said, did not trust them, and some people even hated the things that Jesus taught and did. They arrested Jesus because he said he was God, but he had not done anything wrong. He was telling the truth. They sentenced Jesus to be nailed on a wooden cross, a common way in those days for criminals to die, and the cross was placed between two criminals. Right? And as Jesus hung on the cross, people made fun of him. Yet he said these words, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." How do we treat people that make fun of us? Do we try to point them to God? Okay, Jesus willingly allowed this to happen. And why did God willingly allow it to happen? He did it for each of us. Because if he did not die, we could not have salvation and go to heaven to be with God. And God let himself die on that cross so we could go to heaven to be with him. So he died and he was put in the tomb, and the third day he rose again, number six. The third day he rose again, and this is called the resurrection. And Jesus' death and resurrection prove he really is God, the Son, the promised Messiah. Jesus came alive again and was seen by his disciples, his friends, and hundreds of people. And then he went back to heaven without dying again. And you know, God is coming back soon. Just as he went up, he will be coming back to get those of us who believe in him. Do you know Jesus this morning? If you don't, you can. And we can ask him to come into our hearts and forgive us, and he will. And thank you. You are a good picture holder. Okay, so what were these colors? Let's go through these colors again. What does gold mean?
Gold means heaven.
Okay, say it together. Gold means heaven. The black means sin. And red is for salvation. Okay, and we have a couple more colors to do. But right now, we're going to sing Halloween.
You want to help, Betty?
No? Do you want to help? Okay, Chloe, you want to help? Okay. Now we're going to do Hallelujah. Okay. No, we're just going to do this side and that side. Do you want to come over here and help this side? Okay. Josiah, can you sing with this side too?
I could.
Okay. Okay, we're going to see who can sing the loudest. Who do you think is going to win? Stand up.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise ye, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Okay, we thank you for coming this morning, and we'll have a prayer, and then Chloe, can you pay worship? We thank you, Lord, for your many blessings. Be with the children this morning as they go home. Be with them as they finish their school this month, and help us, Lord, to do our very best to love you and to place our heart in your hands. Amen.